Hi everyone, it's Laura with Yoga Den, and I'm here to get our deep stretch class started. I'll give everyone a few moments to hop on here and to gather any props that you may like for your practice today. Hi Kathy. Hey Jacqueline. How are you ladies? Thank you for joining me. Hi, Nomi. So glad to see your name pop up in your face. Hi, Yuda. Awesome, we've got a good group here. Hi, Michelle. Miss seeing y'all in person, but I'm so glad you're here for our deep stretch. Now, I'll give you a moment to gather any props that you'd like. If you don't have a bolster at home, totally fine. You may want to grab a couple pillows. A blanket may be nice for a little support under the knees. And a yoga strap alternative is a men's tie or a belt. Hey, Davida and Tracy. So glad y'all are here. We'll get started in just a moment, but if you don't have these items nearby, you may want to grab a couple pillows, a blanket for some support under the knees, and then a men's tie or a belt to serve as your yoga strap. I'll take a look at the time. Awesome, we've got a good group here. Grab your props if you haven't already. And I'm actually gonna start with a quick standing warm-up. And the reason being, we typically do this class in a heated room, and we do want the body to be warm. So we're gonna take just a moment here to warm up the body and bring some blood into those areas before we move on to some of the deeper stretches. Hi, Lana. Thanks for joining us. Okay, I'm gonna step back on the mat. Wanna make sure that you can still see and hear me okay. So I'll be popping up towards the camera from time to time to read your comments. Just know that I can't always see them when I'm step back here. Before we begin, I wanna make sure you can see my feet and my placement here on the mat. We're gonna move into a Tai Chi style warm-up. So I invite you to join me. I've got a pillow and a blanket nearby, and a strap. Yoga block can be substituted with a stack of books. And again, these are just options, so you can do this class without props if you don't have anything nearby. No problem. What I'd like you to do is come into a wide stance here. If you're in my barre class, this is our second position, even though we're here for a stretch today. Our feet are turned out 45 degrees, and let's bring the arms low here in front. Now we're going to connect breath to movement to really bring some warmth into these areas before we begin our stretch. So what I'd like you to do is, as you inhale, bring the hands up, the arms up, and then when we exhale, the arms are coming down and we're taking a small plie. So we inhale, straighten those legs, arms come up, exhale, push the air down. Just getting the body warm here. Inhale up, exhale, we plie down. Inhale and exhale. Think of your breath as energy and imagine yourself moving that energy. Inhale and exhale. Good work. Let's do four more. And three. Two. And one. Now I'd like you to hold arms come out front. We're holding a ball of energy here. In just a moment, holding the bend in your legs, we're going to turn the upper body to the right. The arms come down and across. Deep in the plie and come back over to the right. Six more times. And five. Feeling those legs getting warmer. Four. And three. Two. And one. And we're going to reverse. Over to your left. Still holding that plie. We come down and across. This is seven. And six, five, and four. Three more times here. And two, and one. Back to center. Arms come down, straighten the legs. Already feeling a little warmer here, good job. We're gonna heel toe in. Feet are hip distance apart. Now bring those arms overhead, soften the knees, and we're gonna take four full body circles down and around to the right. Four. And three. Two. And one. And let's reverse, other way, four. Strap, go ahead. Otherwise, better than when you got on the mat. Now we'll release. Maybe lift that front leg and hug it in towards the body. Flex the foot. A few little hip circles. Out and in. And we're going to repeat on the other side. Nice quad stretch here. Maybe using your strap or your tie or your band. Remember to keep the knees next to one another. That leg comes back and we lift. Maybe the strap comes onto the shoulder. You can stay here for a little while. Breathing. Careful not to lock the standing leg. And then you do have some options here. Maybe you lift that strap overhead a little higher and the leg comes back. Deeper stretch. Or we place the hand on top of the foot or inside and continue stretching. Let's take three more breaths here. And two. And one. Now before we have a seat and continue our class here, I'd like you to move into a gentle forward fold. So we're going to soften the knees, inhale the arms up. Exhale, swan dive forward, knees are soft, and fold. So maybe the fingertips come towards the floor like so. Then the chin comes toward the chest. Grabbing opposite elbows, a little twist. Waking up those hamstrings. Continue to breathe. And we're going to plant the hands on the shins or the thighs. Inhale, halfway lift. Here, I want you to think about opening the heart, squeezing the pencil between those shoulder blades. Exhale, fold. Come on down one more time. With an optional twist here. So if you'd like, we'll wrap the hands around the right leg and bend that left knee. Right arm reaches up and we twist. Breathe. Slowly coming down and other side. Hands come around that left leg, we bend the right knee. Left arm comes up with a twist. Three breaths here. And one. Come on back down. Maybe you're able to bring the palms towards the floor or the fingertips. Soften the knees as you come up, shoulders come around and back. Now, we're moving on to the seated portion of our class, and we're going to start with legs up the wall. So what I'd like you to do is come as close to the wall as you can here. We'll bring one hip up against the wall, like so. Now, in just a moment, we're going to slowly lower the body as the legs go up, like so. Now, I'll be keeping track of time for us. You may need to shimmy a little closer to the wall. And then I want you to tune into the jaw, chin, and forehead. See if you can release some tension there. And what we're doing is giving our feet and ankles and legs a break here. This is also restorative for the heart. Feeling grounded here as we prepare to work into the hips for some deeper stretches. Let's stay with me here. This can be a great time to tune into the breath. intention for the rest of your practice. Breathing in peace and kindness. Breathing out fear and anxiety. Breathe in compassion and generosity. Breathe out negativity. Now, if this isn't accessible for you, you can also come onto your back and place a couple pillows under the knees. You do want to be careful with legs up the wall if you have blood pressure or heart issues. So notice how you're feeling. And come onto one side if you're lightheaded or not feeling quite yourself. Let's focus on what's happening on the four corners of your mat, with your body and your breath. Give your mind permission to be at ease, to soften the body. Maybe feel yourself getting heavier and heavier into your mat. As we continue with legs up the wall, you may want to explore how it feels to open the legs. Notice I'm moving slowly here in either direction. Let the legs get heavier until you feel a nice stretch in the inner thighs, the outside of the legs, and the groin. You can always come back up a little if it's too intense. Enjoy the sensation. You'll notice as you stay here a little longer, your legs get heavier, and you're able to deepen the stretch just where you're comfortable. Find your personal edge. It's different for each one of us. Recognize that difference between a little discomfort and pain, and modify. Perhaps we slowly begin to bring the legs back up. As we have the option, we come into our supported cobbler's pose. So feet together, knees open. You'll place the hands on top on the sides of the knees here to open the legs a little further. Keep those sit bones rooted. Soften the shoulders. Unclench the jaw and breathe. Bringing in more courage and resilience, patience and inner strength. We're here for four or five more breaths. And then we slowly close the legs like pages of a book. Hands wrap around the front of the legs. Maybe we interlace the fingers or behind the thighs. You have the option to lift the head up towards the knees, feeling a stretch down the spine. And breathe. Bring the head back down. And we're ready to move into our figure four stretch. So what I'd like you to do is extend the left leg slowly up the wall. The right leg is bent, and we're going to cross the right heel in front of the left knee, moving slowly here. You'll feel a gentle opening in the hip. Let's stay here for a moment. Arms can rest
with palms down on the floor. Then I invite you to deepen the stretch at your pace by bending the left leg, and the left foot comes onto the wall. You'll feel this right away in that right hip flexor. Stay here with me. Good work. As you continue to stretch, maybe you bring that left foot down the wall just a bit more. Stay rooted in the mat. We don't want one hip coming too far up. And we're here for 5 more breaths. And after your next exhale, very slowly begin to straighten that left leg up the wall. Uncross the leg, the right foot is planted on the wall, and then we're very slowly going to start reversing. So the right leg straightens, the left leg bends, we bring the left heel in front of the right knee, keeping in mind each side is different. Now for me, my left side is usually a little tighter. Breathing before we slowly begin to introduce a possible bend in the right leg. Keep those hips grounded. And stretch here with me. Notice the jaw, the shoulders. Let's stay open through the heart. Finding grounding through your breath. Maybe deepen the stretch just a little. You'll notice right away. Stay with me here. It may feel nice to rock a little bit. Three more breaths, giving your body permission to release. Laying down some of those burdens you've been carrying, if only during this practice. Feeling a little lighter. And we want to very gently start to straighten that right leg. We uncross and plant the left foot. And now we're going to hug the knees in one more time. Lifting the head as an option. Slowly come down. And I'd like you to roll onto one side. So maybe if you're near the wall, walk those feet. As you roll onto one side, resting the head on the arm, and breathing. And slowly coming up. Now we're moving into our half frog. So if you have a blanket or something that you can fold nearby, go ahead and grab that. Is we're going to come onto our tummy and we're going to place the blanket under our right knee. So I'll walk you through this here.
going to slowly place the chin on the hands. Maybe move the hips a little. Allow yourself to melt and release. And then we'll begin to bend the right leg so that the knee is in line with the hip. So you'll notice that my leg is out to the side here. My knee is in line with the hip. And the right foot is flexed. The shin is running along the side of the mat. And this is our half frog pose. It allows us to gently open that hip just a little bit more. And you can rest here on with the chin on the hands, or it may feel nice to slowly rest on the right cheek as you gaze toward the left. See what feels best for you here. You may prefer to look over to the right. We do want a little support under that knee. As you rest here, you notice that your body's clearing pockets of tension. Send your energy to those places. Use your breath and settle in just a little bit deeper. We're here for five more breaths. And three. And after your next exhale, let's slowly bring that right leg back into the center line of the body. Your blanket will come over to your other side. And we're going to repeat this half frog on your left. Slowly open as you bend that left leg. The knees in line with the hip. The foot is flexed, shins running down the side of the mat, and we'll bring the head to rest on the hands or on one cheek or the other. Half frog on the other side. Let's take five more breaths here together. next exhale, a nice place for a lot of us is child's pose, especially after half frog. And we've got a couple options. You can move into your traditional child's pose, knees open, big toes together, reaching through the arms. Or you can move into a modified child's pose. So if you'd like to modify the pose, especially if your knees give you trouble, let's place the hands under the shoulders and press up. Then we'll bring the legs in front, knees are bent, feet are wide, and we're hinging forward. Maybe wrap the forearms behind the thighs. It's a nice option. Or come into your child's pose. You've got a blanket for some support for the knees here. Bring the legs as wide as it's comfortable for you. Big toes are together. And we'll walk those arms, those hands forward. We want enough space here between the arms for the forehead to come down onto the mat for a more relaxing pose. Or we can keep child's pose more active by pressing through the hands, forearms off the mat, bottom coming close to the heels. What's right for you today? Staying here, or maybe walking the arms over to the right. Left hand on top of the right. Feeling some compression down the abs into the thigh. Stretching the side body. Over to the left. Right hand on top of the left. Slowly back to center. We'll hold here for just a moment. And then walk the hands in closer to the body as we come into our easy seat. I'm sitting on my blanket, legs are crossed, and I'm allowing my arms to hang by my sides, fingertips just slightly on the floor here. Lengthen through the spine and crown. Check in with your shoulders. You're doing a wonderful job. Maybe float the eyes closed and take a few breaths here. It can also feel nice to place the hands on the heart.
and two. Release that hand and arm. Slowly come up to neutral, and we'll repeat on the other side, left ear to left shoulder. Breathing here, with the option to send that left arm out, and place the hand on top of the ear. Four more breaths. Feels good to release some of that tension in the neck. Taking care. Maybe we release the hand and arm and return to neutral. From here, we'll bring the chin toward the chest. You can stay here, letting the head hang heavy, or we can interlace the fingers, place the hands behind the head, and create a little bit more of a curve in the spine as we deepen the stretch. We're ready to move into our forward fold. And if you do have a couple of pillows nearby or a blanket, let's make use of whatever props you have to support you in this fold. So for some of us, it may feel nice to stack the blankets on the top of the legs as we hinge forward, allowing the feet to splay open a little for more of a restorative fold. You can even roll your blanket up or stack some blocks for some support here under the chin. That's one option if you'd like a little bit more of a deep stretch. You can grab your tie or your strap. You're going to place it behind the feet. Notice it's near the ball of the feet. And then I'm hinging forward. I'm keeping my spine long, looking at the toes, and stretching. You can also start out with a little bit more of a restorative forward fold, and then deepen as you move through the stretch. It'd be nice to have support here with the strap or the tie, or you may find that you prefer to place the hands behind the feet and fold. My feet are flexed here to keep this a little bit more active, pulling balls of the feet to deepen. We're using my strap, chest coming closer to the knees. Stretch if you would like to make any adjustments or deepen a little further. Coming back to your breath always. Take four more breaths. And we are going to very slowly start to come up after your next exhale. We'll set the strap or the pillows aside. Hands come behind the hips, elbows are bent, let's pedal out the legs, open and close.
to bend the right leg and plant that right foot. Interlace the fingers in front of the knee. And in just a moment, we're going to cross the right leg over the left. The arms come up. And we're going to place the left elbow outside of the right knee as we twist to the right, fingertips touching the mat behind, just lightly, and breathing. Keep that left foot flexed. Untwisting arms coming up. Now from here, we can take a half a shoelace or a half a wing. So for a deeper stretch, we're going to place the left hand on top of the right foot and bring that right foot close to the left hip. Notice my knees are stacked. This is one option. Another is to create a half a wing. Knee is open, foot's alongside the leg. From here, nice and tall on the spine, with the option to slowly hinge forward, maybe reaching towards that left foot, or using your strap. We're halfway there. Three more big breaths with me. Very slowly coming up, we'll plant that right foot outside of the left knee. Interlace the fingers, walk it back over, and release. Pedal things out before we repeat on the other side. So we're bending the left leg, planting the left foot, and crossing. Arms come up, right elbow outside of the left knee, left arm reaching behind, gentle twist here. Keep that right foot flexed, and keep the length in the spine, the fingers just lightly here on the mat, and breathe. Three more breaths. And the arms are going to come overhead as we come back to center. Nice breath here. And then we're moving into our half shoelace or half wing. Right hand on top of the left foot beside the right hip. Stacking the knees, we've got that right foot flexed. This is one option, or your half wing. Staying here nice and tall, or hinging forward, reaching for the ball of the foot, and breathing, or using your strap. Good work. Three more nice breaths with me. And after that next exhale, very slowly coming up, uncrossing the leg, pedaling things out. Let's take some windshield wipers here. Feet are about as wide as the mat. And the knees come down right and left. We've done quite a bit of folding. So we'll come to a seated cat-cow before we move into our wide-legged forward fold and our fire log or pigeon. Hands on top of the knees, After your next exhale, we're going to inhale. Open the heart, lift the chin. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Exhale, bring that chin toward the chest. Big stretch for the spine here. Inhale, open. Exhale, curve. Two more times. And moving on to our wide-legged forward fold. You can turn to one side if you're on your mat, or give yourself enough room here to gently straighten the legs and then begin to open. Opening wider than the mat. Lifting up on the sit bones. And coming to your wide-legged preparation here. So we've got the feet flexed. You do have your pillows and some props nearby. If you'd like to place your pillows here between the legs. Feet are flexed. And we'll start to hinge forward. And as we move through this stretch, we can point and flex the feet to keep the legs nice and active. Maybe we're starting with some props and then moving them aside as we deepen. Feeling this in the inner thighs and groin. Taking your time, working with your body. Point and flex. May feel nice to move the props aside and bring the forearms onto the floor. Point and flex the feet. Good work. We're almost there. Maybe you reach those arms, tip the hands, and hold. Point or flex the feet. Careful the shoulders don't come up by the ears. Now from here, let's slowly bring the hands in towards the body. It may feel nice to come over to the right. Keep the heart open. Reach with the left arm. Notice my shoulders are stacked. My feet are pointed, or you can flex. Let's go over to the other side. One more nice stretch to the center for four breaths. And three. Notice I'm slowly bringing the hands towards the body. And then gently bringing the legs together. They're going to be a little sore right now. Let's pedal things out. Or take some windshield wipers. Nice and easy. You should be proud of yourself for taking this time for yourself and your body. We're coming into a cobbler's pose. Feet together, knees open, hands around the feet, tall through the spine before I hinge forward. Looking a few feet in front of me here to keep some length in the spine. My elbows are bringing the knees closer to the floor. May feel nice to massage the arches of the feet. Giving the feet some attention. Squeezing the toes. And slowly coming up. Now we're moving into our fire walk pose. And we have sequenced the class in a way to really prepare your body for this deep stretch. You may have a couple of books or a blanket nearby as an option. But what I'd like you to do is, you've got one leg crossed in front of the other in your easy seat. It doesn't matter which leg is in front. And I'd like you to join me in lifting that front leg so that you can stack the heel on top of the knee. And then for the foot that's on the bottom here, I'm going to walk it forward just a little so that that top knee is over the heel. It's normal to have some space here. You may have quite a bit. This is where you can use your blanket, your pillow, your block, your books, whatever you have, to place it in that space there. This way we're grounding. We have a nice connection to the floor. And we're here together in our fire log. It's important to keep the feet flexed here. I have to remind myself, it's going to be a little healthier for the knees and it helps to keep the stretch more active. Now we can stay here, nice and tall, really feel a deep stretch in the hip flexors of that leg that's on the top. Or it may feel nice to begin to hinge forward. I'm going to keep some length in the spine. I like to place my forearms on that top leg. And look at the floor, a few feet in front. Or you may wish to extend those arms and fold forward. This is our big final stretch here. And we've really worked up to it. So now it's time to allow the body to settle in and reap the benefits of your practice. We're near the halfway point. This can sometimes be a nice place to remove the block or the blanket just to see if that top leg is ready to come down a little bit more as we continue to fold. Always bring back in the blanket or the block. If this is too intense or your body's not quite ready, check in with the feet. Let's keep those flexed. Maybe the forearms are resting or the fingertips are reaching. Good work. Breathing. And very gently, let's come up and uncross. Your breath is here to support you. Let's melt a little deeper into the spinal stretch. Accepting some of the discomfort. Tuning into that sense of resilience. Slowing down each exhale before we gently begin to come up and slowly across. Bring those legs in front, pedal things out. Definitely want to windshield wiper. So plant the feet about as wide as the mat, soften the elbows, and bring the right and the left knee down. I've so enjoyed this deep stretch with you. Hope it felt nice for your body today. Know that you can always rewatch this class at a later time on our Facebook page and perhaps on YouTube. But for now, we're ready to settle into our final resting pose. So we've got the feet planted. You can always bring some pillows under the knees. We'll slowly lower back. And may feel nice to hug the knees in toward the chest, shifting the weight, or taking your half happy baby on the right or left, or your full happy baby. Whatever you'd like to close out your practice with, maybe the legs come up or they open. We have time for an inversion. And then when you're ready, we'll move into our final resting pose. If your low back is talking to you, you can walk those knees together and the feet open. Lower back in towards the mat. And tuning into your heart as you soften the chin, jaw, and forehead. Or maybe the legs come down onto the mat one at a time. Allow the feet to gently sway open. Palms coming up. Resting with me here. Giving yourself permission to rest. Stay here as long as you'd like, taking your time, rolling onto one side or the other at your pace. There's no rush. I'm rolling onto one side. You can stay right where you are. Thank you again for joining me. I really hope that this felt nice for your body. I do read your comments. If you have any requests or feedback, I'm always happy to receive it. And I will see you again very soon. I'll be back this week on Tuesday and Thursday for